Well, hello, everybody. Hello, hello. I'm Redrick Preacher, also known as Lainey. It is good to see you. I have been away for a while. I hope you guys are enjoying the September we're having. Because September is my favorite month. There's no holidays to mess it up, and it's absolutely gorgeous no matter where you live. So this message today, I'm like drooling because I literally have like peanut butter off to the side here. I'm not pre-diabetic. I got to eat. So, oh my gosh, Spirit's going to teach us. It's peanut butter jelly time. Peanut butter jelly time. We've got to talk about this. All right, so, hang on. This is good. Peanut butter. All right, we're just going to let Spirit fly here because I did not practice this. I don't have a teleprompter, okay? I got to open Spirit. So, we have the peanut butter, and then we have the jelly. Ironically, Spirit, I was getting ready to make a damn sandwich. Make me a sandwich. And Spirit just got involved with that. So, Spirit got involved with me making a peanut butter jelly sandwich. And he's like, you know, Lainey, it's time to go sit on the porch. Okay. We have two separate entities. A male and a female. For those of you on the spiritual journey, you're going to love this. So, these two things are completely separate. I know that we put them together and we sell them on the shelf, but who really buys the one with the jelly and the peanut butter combined into one jar? I don't think hardly any of us do, okay? So, we buy these separate because they're full and they're in entirety as they are. Jelly is jelly, peanut butter is peanut butter, rah, right? So, as separate as they are and as individual as they are, they're so married together. These two are always, they're married together. Even if they don't sit on the shelf in the same place in the grocery store, these guys are married, all right? They have like a soul contract between them, right? They're always going to come together on a sandwich, right? So that's how that happens, union on bread. Here's the funny thing that I was learning about this, because I have children aging from 9 to 13. You give kids unfettered rights to the peanut butter and jelly jar, and you have like a disgusting, you know, Dr. Ed, you know, Dr. Dreadful lab thing going on. So my kids, they have their own jelly and peanut butter because they're children, and then I have my own. And we all know this. Why is that, Lainey? Kids are reckless. Kids are reckless. And I'm going to make this parallel to us adults in our spiritual relationships, okay? I give my kids their own peanut butter and jelly jars in the kitchen because the kids are reckless and lazy and they cut corners and they're not understanding. So kids make a nasty disaster out of the peanut butter jar so bad that I don't want to get in it because they always leave like jelly glops. Like there's a jelly glop in there now. You see that? And it'll get gummy and stringy and disgusting. And then when I scoop out and make a sandwich, there's that one hard piece of jelly that just turns you off. You're like, and I'm done. Okay, we don't want that in our peanut butter, okay? So, you know, if I go get the jelly jar, it is just as much a mess because it's been dealt with by children who are reckless and fast and they don't care about the cleanliness. So the lid is like sticky. You never want to be around the lid. And then if I just look in here, like it's fine. It's completely fresh. You know, it's maybe like a week old, but there's this coagulated junk of peanut butter around the lid. For like a good inch. Like, that's disgusting. So when I get the peanut butter, you gotta stick your hand in there and it's just nasty. So that my kids have mixed peanut butter into the jelly and they mix the jelly into the peanut butter. And when I come in there like a week later or whatever to make a sandwich, I get the nasties. I get the yucky peanut butter glops out of the jelly and I get the hardened jelly out of the peanut butter in my sandwich and it's gross. So I keep my own jars in the kitchen. Because I'm an adult and I'm aware and I keep the jars like clean and separate and not sticky and disgusting, right? So pointing this out the way that Spirit wanted me to point this out is not only is this like male and female and don't worry about being separate or in different places in life or different places on the shelf, you get the parallel, you will always be in union. These two are married and they'll always go together, okay? Especially on bread. So don't worry about how it's going to come together. It just does, okay? The other thing is, if this is a person with a spiritual house and a heart and a brain and all of that, when you let a lot of people get into your jar, let's say I have three kids, if you let each child get into this jar at different intervals throughout the week, unfettered, okay, by the time you look at yourself, you've been contaminated and you have yucky jelly in your so basically, you have somebody else energy in your energy. And that's disgusting. You're not pure peanut butter no more. You're peanut butter with gidgies in it from children, and that's, nobody wants that. See, hear me? Nobody wants that. And, you know, sometimes peanut butter will get so bad with that with children that they'll just leave it in the cabinet, and we just go on and buy a new one. Okay? So, same thing with your spirit. You let enough goodies get inside of you, and you're not really a clean version of what you should be. You're not spreadable anymore if you have chunks. Nobody's going to want that, and they're going to leave you on the shelf and just go get a new one that's less chunkier than you, okay? Peanut butter's supposed to be creamy, all right? Not chunky with jelly chunks. So, a little lesson on us and how we heal ourselves and get rid of other people that have been in our jar. And the same thing goes with jelly. If this is the sweet feminine, okay? You let too many people in your jar and you got a disgusting sticky lid and there's just peanut butter nastiness and goodies like all over that. Nobody's gonna want that. I don't. I'd rather go buy a new thing of jelly and throw this one in the trash. So if you don't want to be neglected or even put yourself on the shelf or allow other people to walk by and put you on the shelf, don't have shit where it doesn't belong. Don't cross-contaminate. Keep yourselves clean and pure for what you are. And when the two come together, that's when it's beautiful, fresh, and delicious. Okay? All right? So keep your components clean, I guess, is what the message was there. All right? Till dinner time.